Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Human Respiration. In that we are studying topic Character of Respiratory System. Now if I talk about human respiratory system, it needs to be in certain parameters or it needs to have certain tissues and certain organs. Then only we as human beings can breathe properly. Now what are these parameters or features? Let's study about them. Firstly, any respiratory surface or area has to be thin and permeable. Now when I talk about thin and permeable, let's assume the alveoli or the air sacs. Now imagine if your alveoli or your air sacs were thick and impermeable. Do you think that the gaseous exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide would have been possible? Obviously not. It won't be. Secondly, large surface area. If you imagine your respiratory tract eventually starts from your nostrils or noses, including your right and the left cavity of your nose, and then goes from there till your alveoli. In that you have pharynx, larynx, esophagus, bronchi, so it's quite a big area. Obviously you have to inhale and exhale gases, and which is a lifelong process, and molecules of gases are needing large amount of spaces. Moist and highly vascular. Now respiratory systems need to be moist and they have to be vascular, especially in eukaryotic organisms, because prokaryotic organisms will never have so advanced respiratory system. They basically respire with the help of their skin or outer layers of skin or cutaneous or subcutaneous layers of skin. They may be in direct or maybe in indirect contact with the source of oxygen. Now we are inhaling air or gases around our atmosphere or environment just to intake that oxygen, which is vital for our survival. So we need to be around oxygen, obviously, and we have to exhale oxygen, and we need to get oxygen in our systems, and we have to remove carbon dioxide out of our systems. Lastly, the presence of respiratory pigment hemoglobin. If there's no hemoglobin, who will carry oxygen molecule to different tissues? So what are the characteristics that would be needed for a respiratory system to work properly or to carry out that gaseous exchange of material? Let's go through them. Firstly, it must be thin and permeable. Permeability of your alveoli tract or your respiratory system is very necessary, because if that's not present, how will your gases exchange? Also, it should have a large surface area. Your respiratory tract cannot be a smaller area. Then how would gases exchange? How would that gaseous molecules, which would include oxygen, carbon dioxide, if you inhale, it would also include dust particles, nitrogen, where are they going to reside or stay for a period of time till oxygen is kept inside the body and carbon dioxide is removed? Also, it needs to be moist and highly vascular. Now in prokaryotes or in vertebral organisms, this is a requirement which is very necessary. They must be in direct or indirect contact with the source of oxygen or O2. Wherever you're breathing or inspiring that air, it needs to have the presence of oxygen, because that's the thing for which you're breathing, the vital energy molecule. And lastly, there needs to be a presence of respiratory pigment, which is HB or hemoglobin. We all know that oxygen, when it has to be carried to different organs, hemoglobin molecule is a crucial one. Your RBCs, which are biconcave or enucleated on that molecule, your hemoglobin, which is a porphyring ring of ions, attaches, and to which your oxygen molecule attaches, and they travel together. So whenever they have to give an oxygen molecule, this triode travels together, and the oxygen molecules are distributed to the places of tissues, organs, and cells. So hemoglobin is necessary. Now, presence of hemoglobin, also the presence of carbonic anhydrase in the case of human beings to remove out that RBC molecules. It's not necessary that just the hemoglobin or just the carbonic anhydrase can remove or take in oxygen to different places. Certain amount of oxygen and carbon dioxide removal is done by plasma cells of our blood, but that's just 7 to 8%. Rest of the work is done by these two parameters. So students, in this part of the chapter, we did study about the characteristics of respiratory surfaces. Now, in case of animals, these characteristics could vary. For example, in the case of frogs, which is an amphibian, which is a terrestrial animal that lives half of the time on land and half of the time underwater. Now, they respire with the help of their gills as well as with the help of their skin. Now, when they respire with the help of their gills, their respiratory system should have all this quality. But when they respire with the help of their skin, the subcutaneous surface or the skin lesions must contain this property. Similarly, lizards. Now, lizards are terrestrial, they are never aquatic, but even that time, they need to produce certain hormones or chemicals, if I could say, along with this system. Protozoans, amoebites, annelids, earthworm, leeches, aphids, every respiratory system needs to have this quality so that they respire efficiently. Students, in this part of the chapter, we did study about respiratory system or surfaces and how do they function and what are their properties they need to possess to be a fine respiratory system. I hope you are very clear about this concept. Thank you.